Had a drummer from Belgium for two albums. Those were Entrance and Virgin Killer. And his name was Rudy Lennars. And he was a good friend of ours. And we had a great time with him. But we were touring all the time. And in those days, I calculated, I think in 1 year, we had like over 100 concerts, which for a German band was outrageous back then. And we were traveling constantly back then, always either by van or by car, you know, all over France and in England. And Rudy started to develop some health problems with his stomach or whatever it was. And eventually he said, it's not for me, guys. You know, so we had to let him go. And then we had to find a new drummer.
Why I went to London is actually, I had a simple reason. I had my rock and roll dream, and after I didn't find anybody here in Germany. I even auditioned for Amon Dül at the time, Kraftwerk, where they had Birth Control, all those bands. But they were not right then for me for the time, because I wanted to play rock, hard rock. So for me, my dream was to go to England and find in England a heavy hard rock band, a hard rock band. I was hoping maybe Uriah Heep needed a new drummer. This was my dream. So with this dream and with 2,000 Deutschmark in my pocket, I went to London. Of course, after 4 weeks, the 2,000 Deutschmarks were gone. And I had to survive with very, very little money.
We were in London, and we had a gig at a theater in Soho or wherever it was. It was called the Sound Circus. And before the show, we had an audition. We found that we had two guys had been recommended. One guy, I don't remember his name, and the other one was Herman, and Herman had already had some contact with Michael Schenker before, so he was part of the London scene, but he was technically German, you know, Herman Z German.
Around 74, 75, I met Michael Schenker through his wife, Gabi Schenker, through the Marquee Club. To tell the story quick, there was a pub down the road called The Ship, and that's where we used to go to and have a drink, and that's how we became friends and met. And in the spring of 77, Michael told me, my brother has a band in Germany called The Scorpions. They come over here to play at the Marquee Club. Come and check them out. They're looking for a new drummer. Why don't you go for the audition?
I think Herman was recommended also by Michael.
Yeah,
Schenker,
Michael. I think it was Michael.
Because they were hanging out, and Herman was hanging out quite a bit at the at Speakeasy Club.
Yes, Speakeasy.
In London. And so he was highly recommended by Rudolf's brother Michael.
Well, he didn't tell me that many other drummers were also at the audition, you know. But anyway, to make a long story short, I went to the audition. I got the gig, and of course they said to every drummer, we play three songs with you, and then don't phone us, we phone you. They said the same thing to me, so I said, well, never hear from them again.
We jammed with him, and afterwards we, all of us, we agreed, yeah, we'll give it a shot, and that's how Herman got into the band.
Next morning they phoned. Would you like to be our new drummer? Can we take your drums with us to Hanover right now? So all this happened actually really the next day. They took the drums, and I was supposed to fly a week after this from London to Hanover.
We gave him a ticket right away to...
A ticket?
Get himself to Germany.
Oh, okay.
And yeah. But he went to the airport, and the ticket was not working, wasn't worth anything.
Unfortunately, the ticket was given to me was one of those cheap tickets where you could not exchange when you travel. You had to fly on the day it says on the ticket.
Herman called me and said, Rudolf, what this ticket is not working. Said, okay, we send you the money and you can buy it by yourself.
A week later, I flew then finally to Hanover.
So this was the very beginning with Herman. We were all excited and he was excited. We said, Herman, but come on, we were there with our truck. You know, I think we had this Mercedes.
We had a big 4.506 or 406
something like that.
Van, which I drove all over England.
All the way.
You guys were in the other Merc, nice and comfortable. But I loved it. It was great, particularly anyway, the first tour. And then that was, I think, the third tour.
Those days
tour.
We went all the way to Dover, I think, right? To go.
We had to do it all ferry. On the first one we did in our van, which was a big van, and you know, you could even sleep in that van. And then afterwards we had split cars. We still had the van, and then we had this white Mercedes. Rudolf had a white Mercedes that we used as a band car.
So you drove the truck and I was with Rudolf in the white Mercedes?
Yes. I have proof of that on camera.
Oh, this is a fucked up situation. I wonder what I'm getting myself in here, you know. My drums is already gone, is already in Germany. So I phoned Rudolf and I said, look, the ticket is not working. And Holger Luczynski, their tour manager at the time, and the guy who was responsible for the pyrotechnics and the fireworks, he gave me the ticket and said, don't worry, I know it's not the date, you know. And I told him, this is cheap ticket, it's not going to work. But this is the ticket I had. So anyway, Rudolf sent me another ticket, which took a few days. And a week later, I flew over to Bremen. You remember Beat Club in Bremen? And in my plane was Dolly Parton with her whole band flying to Bremen to record the Beat Club. And I took the train from Bremen to Hanover, and Rudy Lenners, the ex-drummer, or the drummer at the time, picked me up at the railway station and took me to a small hotel. And the same evening, I was picked up again for the wedding from Klaus Meiner.
Anyway, we arrived in time somehow, and it was just about the time I was getting married, and we had a nice party in 1977, and this is when we were hanging out for the very first time.
I remember the date, it was the 18th of May, the day Klaus Meiner got married.
I remember very well, in those days, everybody in the band thought it was totally uncool to dance. I mean, we were musicians, we were up on stage, we were playing. And, you know, wherever, and in those days, and the clubs we played, I mean, when it came to dancing, you know, it was definitely not us. But in my wedding party, you know,
we
that night,
danced.
Everybody
we
went on
danced.
The dance floor.
I danced.
And I remember that it was so hilarious. We all had a great time.
That's when I met Dieter Dirks, also same place. And all the people, the crew, everybody there. But this is how I came to the Scorpions.
It was the beginning of a wonderful long stretch of making albums and touring around the world. And so Herman came in to the Scorpions at the right moment.